going. It's the 25th of October, and yeah, it's the weekend. It's the weekend, peoples. Danny just went over to day shift. He does like one week night shift and 1 week day shift, so he's just gone over to day shift today. I honestly, I lose my bearings on this when he changes shift. But yeah, so he's on day shift now. One more week and then he'll be home next Thursday. It was kind of funny this morning. I was having breakfast, and because Daniel, he surprised me yesterday. He so surprised me yesterday. He came home and he's like, came home from school and he's like, Mum, I made you something. And I'm going, oh, cool, oh, goody, what did you make? So he came out and he made me this cinnamon roll because they had home ec yesterday at school. And yeah, he was so surprised to give it to me. He was really, 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 really wrapped to give it to me. And I was just like, oh, wow, yeah, that is so nice. That is so nice, son. So I just finished eating that for breakfast. But at the same time as I was having brekkie, he was sort of like creeping around the house. And so I stopped him in his tracks. I said, son, why are you creeping around the house? Why are you sneaking around the house like that? And he's like, oh, I'm not doing anything. I'm going, yes, you are. You're creeping around. I can see you. And then anyway, he had this money in his hand and it was like all loose change that he had. I says, I got your money. I says, I got your money. I got your lunch money. And he's like, oh, no. I guess, no, I'll just use this. I said, oh, my gosh. I said, you got like 5 cent pieces and 10 cent pieces. Those people are going to take all the aids to count it all. And then he goes, no, it's all right. So he refused to take money. I says, look, your father left me money to especially give you, to make sure that you eat during the day. And then he refused to take it, so he just went off to school. But I just say to him, I says, you have money for lunches for the whole week until your father gets home. But he says, oh no, I'll take it next week, I'll take it on Monday. So yeah, little bugger. This has been a right sneaky little creep this morning. But that was okay. I'll go tell you people. He's got this, Daniel has this really, really shiny personality about him. I mean, you're like, he's the sort of type of kid that can walk into a room and brighten up a person's day. And that's how he is. He hates being judgmental. He hates judging on other people. And yeah, any negativeness that he hears from other people, he switches off. He just doesn't have the tolerance for it. So, which, hey, I 100% agree with him. I don't like judgmental people either. So, not only does that piss me off, of course, but I mean, it's just a whole lot of waste of energy. But Daniel, he has this whole personality about him to where people ask where he is if he's not with me. He's like, people, first thing they will say, oh, where's Daniel? And, but yeah, he's one of these kids that can actually make your day bright when you're down. And, he's just like, creeped me up. He just so creeped me up this morning because, like, I says, Daniel, you don't need to be creeping around the house. If you need anything, just ask me. Just don't go creeping around the house. But yeah, he cracks me up, But he's at this age now, he's like 12 years old. He's really mature for his age, he's at this age to where he wants his own freedom, where he wants to do whatever he thinks he could do. Like, catching trains and buses into the city and to the beaches with his mates, only just him and his mates. No other family, just him and his mates, so they can get up to no good. So anyway, that because we got Halloween coming up next week, and he has already organised him and his buddies to go over to the Haven, which is on the other side. It's a Newish suburb on the other side of us. So he's obviously made plans with his friends to go out Halloween on, I think it must be next week, Thursday or something like that. So I said, well, you know what? I mean, I do Halloween too. I always like to have a big bowl of lollies for the, especially for the little ones, because they always dress up in their little cute little costumes and their little Halloween cute costumes, and I like giving lollies to them. But I said to Daniel, I says, if you're going to do that, if you're going to go around scamming lollies, I suggest that you dress up, because I will flatly refuse to give any kids, especially his age, like little 12-year-olds, that they can just go knocking on doors asking for lollies without any kind of Halloween costume. So anyway, I says to him that we'll go down to the shop sometime next week and we'll pick him up. And the thing about it too is, I think because Halloween is on Thursday, and it's the day that his father flies in. And he was like shattered. And I go, oh my gosh, if Halloween's on Thursday, Daniel, your father flies in on Thursday. And he's going, no, I'm not going to go to the airport. I'm always going to the airport to pick him up. And I go, you pick him up. I go, it's me that picks him up, not you. And then he's going, no, I don't want to come out this Thursday. I want to go Halloween. So I says, all right, okay. So I'm going to let him go. I'll just go alone and pick up his father. So, but yeah, he is such a wonderful kid. He is such a beautiful kid. He, like I said, he does not pass judgment on anybody. He does not, he hates the criticism. Because he's such a positive, he's a really positive, good positive vibe, and he doesn't like it. He doesn't like people passing judgment on other people. So I'm so happy he's like that. Mind you, all my kids are like that. They don't like to pass judgment on anybody. So But anyway, I'll go in about 10 minutes. I've got to go and pick up my son-in-law. He has his op today, and he cannot drive, so I'm going to be picking him up and taking him to the hospital. And then, people. My son. My creepy little son. Anyway, I'm gonna leave you guys, so I'm gonna love and leave you guys. So if you like this video, hit the likes, notification, comment, and also thank you to all the new subscribers that channeled into my video, my YouTube. Thank you again, and I hope they're not too boring for you. And so don't forget to subscribe, and I'll catch you in my next vid. So you guys have a good weekend, and I will catch you whenever. See ya.